Superman. This rare 72-inch door panel of the Man of Steel was printed in 1971 and was in poor condition. We gave it a poster fix. Hi, I'm Chris, and welcome to another edition of Posterfix Studio.
When we got this Superman poster, he was damaged. He had been rolled for a long time. There are no fold creases in it, but there is this rippling, as you can see, caused by it being rolled for many years. There's also some what looks like wear here, perhaps done by something acidic spilling onto the poster, causing it to eat through the paper. And there's got to be a paper fill put here. This was published by Poster Prints.
This is a rare vintage giant size original Superman peace sign door panel poster from 1971. This rare life-size poster measures about 72 inches tall by 24 inches wide. It's much more impressive in person than it looks on a computer screen. And now we're going to Linenback and restore this poster. Don't go away, we'll be right back.
Welcome back to Posterfix. We are going to Linenback this big door panel poster of Superman now.
For those of you who don't know what linenbacking is, it's an archival mounting process. We mount the poster using wheat paste to a piece of acid-free paper and cotton canvas. This gives you an archival backing, a backing which is not bad for paper. It doesn't eat away at the paper. It helps to neutralize the acids, makes the poster stronger so it'll last longer, and also provides a base from which you can do further restoration, such as paper fills, etc. And that's what I'm doing now, linen backing the poster. I've already prepared the screen with the acid-free paper. If you want to see how that's done, you can watch another video. I've got many videos that shows the entire preparation process that occurs before we actually linen back. But for the sake of expediency, I'm skipping that now and just getting right to the linen backing of the poster. The Man of Steel. What I've done is I laid the poster down onto the acid-free paper. I've applied the wheat paste to the acid-free paper to avoid further damage to the poster. And now I'm spraying water to the poster so that the poster will expand. It's expanding from the wheat paste and from the water. Now I am rolling out the poster gently without scratching the surface. We need to push out the excessive wheat paste as well as the air pockets, and that is the purpose of rolling it out. It also helps the poster to stretch. And in case you might not know who Superman is, which is not very likely, I'm going to read to you the synopsis from Wikipedia. Superman is a fictional superhero who first appeared in American comic books published by DC Comics. The character was created by writer Jerry Siegel and artist Joe Shuster, and first appeared in the comic book Action Comics No. 1, cover dated June 1938 and published April 18, 1938. Superman has been adapted to a number of other media, including radio serials, novels, movies, and television shows, as well as theater. I am now wiping down Superman with a sponge to make sure all the excess wheat paste has been cleaned off the surface. Superman popularized the superhero archetype and defined its conventions. Superheroes are usually judged by how closely they resemble the standard established by Superman. He was the best-selling superhero character in American comic books up until the 1980s.
And now we've got Superman linen back. I'm going to let this screen dry for a few days before we trim the posters down and do the touch-up. So don't go away. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to Posterfix. My wife, Oki, is preparing this poster to get restored first with paper fills. We're analyzing the corruption of the color.
It looks like some kind of acidic liquid spilled on it and caused the ink to run. That's all I said. Anyway, whatever the liquid was, it dripped down. I think it was acidic or something. But it's not that much touch-up.
This kind of paper is very picky. Very hard to match.
I know what you mean. Yeah. That blue is hard to match. But you know, yeah, it's I don't think it's going to be too hard. This one might be the worst. Maybe we should paint the whole thing. But I don't think it's necessary, really. It's not going to be that good.
This part is harder to. This part is hard to match.
No, it's hard to match.
Somebody had put a sticker on Superman's face and then tried to pull it off, thereby damaging the poster and leaving the residue of the sticker. So now we're taking the residue of the sticker off with naphtha.
Camera. This part is already pulled off by somebody?
Yeah.
I need to report it.
This poster was featured in Silver Age DC comic book advertisements, and I believe this poster was not available in stores. I think you could only acquire one through mail order, and there can't possibly be many of these posters left in existence, because there probably weren't that many manufactured, and most have probably been displayed, lost, or destroyed by now. I believe it features the artwork of longtime Silver Age DC Action Comics artist Kurt Swan, or possibly Justice League of America GLA artist Murphy Anderson, but I'm not 100% sure of which.
Yeah, what's going on?
Yeah, from here it looks lighter. The original color.
This one is lighter?
No, I'm saying that this area looks lighter than this area. Slightly. Could be just the light in here too. very subtle, it's hard to tell. Here it looks fine. Here it looks a little light. I don't know why. This in here looks darker than this. And that's probably why.
Don't go away. We'll be right back. If you have any questions about the restoration of your vintage posters, don't hesitate to send me an email telling me the size and condition of the poster, show me some photos of the posters, and if possible, photograph the back of them too if there are issues that I should know about on the back, like writing or tape or residue of some kind. I look forward to seeing your posters and getting back to you with an estimate for the restoration work. Thank you. Welcome back to Posterfix. Now that we've trimmed down the poster, Oki is going into it with water reversible gouache to retouch those areas of the blue and in the white that had paper fills or, in the case of the blue area, color missing from that strange acidic spillage. The gouache she is using is water reversible.
I think it's okay too. Yeah. Okay.
Somebody had put a sticker on Superman's face and then tried to pull it off, thereby damaging the poster and leaving the residue of the sticker. So now we're taking the residue of the sticker off with naphtha.
Hi, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good. Hi. I'll be right with you, sir.
Hi, this is Chris. Can I help you? Yes, this is Posterfix. You say you have a poster you want to have fixed? What's the size and condition? Okay, and around what period was it printed in? The 1940s, 30s? Oh, okay. I want you to send me an email if you can. Can you do that with pictures of the poster so I can see the condition better? That would be great. Okay, I look forward to seeing the email and I'll get back to you with an estimate for the work. Thank you for calling Posterfix.
Thank you.
Have a nice day.